So we're going to continue looking at wiring diagrams for lighting circuits. In a previous presentation, we looked at a one-way lighting circuit. You walk into a room, there's a switch, turns on the light in the room. We're going to extend that now to two-way switching. So we've got two positions of which we can turn on the light. This is common for bottom of the stairs, turns on the landing light. You walk up the stairs to go to bed, say. You can turn off the landing light from a switch in a different position from two ways. So we've got two switches on here. Remember, these will represent the connections within a two-way switch, as will the ceiling rose or batten lamp holder here. Remember from the first presentation, the connections within the consumer unit won't exactly look like it does on the drawing, but shows us the fuse, the neutral link, and the earth connection for the CPCs. So let's have a look at what we've got then. So we've got two-way switches. So you walk into a bedroom, you turn on the light, you walk to another position, and you can turn off that light. Okay, so you've got two-way switching. The wiring that we looked at previously for a one-way lighting circuit here is very similar from this section here up and this section here down. All of these sections here are identical what we're going to do now, except we won't have a one-way switch here, we will have a two-way switch. So this is a two-way switch, so it's one gang, so in other words there's only one switch on it, but as we look here, we can see it's two-way. There is a common, an L1 and L2 as well. It doesn't matter, I could have turned it round, there's common, L1 and L2. It's only important that we get the commons correct, and we'll look at that in the drawing. L1 and L2 can flick as they go between them, but students tend to like to keep them in the same place, but you don't have to. So this is a one gang two-way switch, and we need two of those. And as before, we've got here the base of a ceiling rose or pendant. So again, exactly the same as we had before. We've got that base with two terminals here for switching line, insulated away from three terminals here for the loop, and then insulated away from three terminals here for the neutral, and a connection for our circuit protective conductors. Likewise here, exactly the same setup. We've got 2, 3, 3, and a CPC connection as well. So that's what we're going to be looking at. We're looking at how we're going to make our connections for a wiring diagram to help us do two-way switching of a light fitting. We're going to be using, again, PVC, PVC twin, and CPC cables. So I know in the past at college I have used twin brown, and I talked about it in the first video down to the switches, but I'm going to keep it using twin and CPC. So we've got a brown, a blue, and a circuit protective conductor, which we'll identify in the drawing with green and yellow to identify the green and yellow sleeving that would go on top of that for identification purposes. It's 1 mm² in my college, it might be 1.5 in the real world. Remember, we're chucking this cable away after each of our lighting circuits, so we might as well chuck away 1 mm cable rather than 1.5. We're going to introduce a new cable as well, so we're going to have to use this cable here. This being a 3-core and CPC, so we've got brown, black, and grey, so we need those colours for our drawings as well, and a bare conductor again, which will be identified as our circuit protective conductor. So let's do the first part, which I said was identical to when we did our one-way lighting circuit. So if you've got a one-way lighting circuit in a room, you can easily turn it into a two-way lighting circuit by simply adding one more cable between the switch. So if you had a switch at the door and you wanted to put a switch somewhere else into a bedroom, you just simply put a 3-core cable between the two and change the original one gang one-way switch for a two-way switch. That links in with the first video we looked at. Remember, I'd expect you to be using a ruler. I'm doing it upside down, and obviously I'm doing it freehand, but I'd expect you to use a ruler. We'll start off with a line connection here. For us, it's coming out of the consumer unit, so out the top of the circuit breaker. It could be, and we talked about in a previous video, it could be coming from the next room. It's still gonna bring in the same connections. So we're gonna bring in our permanent line connection, and we're gonna use any of the three here in the center loop. Make it easier for my drawing, I'm actually gonna use this one here on the end. So I'm gonna just pull that one down, and then we're gonna bring the two together. Remember, I'm doing this freehand. I expect you to use a ruler. So that's brought our permanent line connection into the block of three in the center, which is loop. These are not connected to the lamp. Remembering the lamp itself will have a neutral on one side and a switching line on the other side. And we wouldn't want a permanent connection to the line to be across the lamp, because the lamp would illuminate all the time. So the cable is a PVC, PVC twin and CPC. We've used the brown. So let's use the blue in this case, which is a neutral. So let's bring the neutral in. So I'm gonna take it out of this one here. I'm gonna bring it from here. And then we're gonna bring that one across to join those two up. So we've now got the neutral connection coming into the block of three marked with an N in our ceiling rose or pendant. So we've got the block of three there for our neutral. Okay, we've used the loop terminal for a permanent line. And we're now going to bring in the final connection, which is our CPC. So from the consumer unit to here. We talked about in a previous video, didn't we, that the CPC isn't really required for these type of light fittings because they are fully insulated, they're all plastic, but we know light fittings can easily be changed for metal ones, making them exposed conductive parts. Just putting a little striking line down the side there so it's actually green and yellow. It's only one cable, remember, that's not two cables, that's just trying to show the outer green and yellow sleeving. Okay, is what we're trying to do there. So that brings our first cable in. So it's come from the consumer unit, line, neutral and CPC. So line, neutral and CPC is brought in like so, and it's connected into the loop, any of the three, it doesn't matter which one, into the neutral, okay, any of the three, doesn't matter, and into the terminal, which is for the circuit protective conductor, like so here, remember, fully insulated, but it can be changed for a metallic fitting, which is an exposed conductive part in the future, and a CPC will be needed. So that's our 1mm² cable coming in, identical to what we did in our previous video. So when we looked at our one-way lighting circuit, we did exactly the same. And then we took a cable down, which was also 1mm², which had brown, blue, and a CPC. We're gonna do the same again. Start by doing the CPC. So we're just gonna bring a cable down here. So we're gonna bring down our CPC, like so. Again, some of my students do like to strike a little yellow down the side. So our CPC comes down. We're gonna bring down our permanent line connection. So the permanent line coming out of the loop, there's two terminals left. Okay, it doesn't matter which one I choose, but I'm gonna bring down my permanent line connection. And it doesn't matter whether it goes in L1 or L2. So as we look at our switch, we've got it here. We've got common on its own and L1 and L2. Okay, so we've got common, and we've got L1 and L2. It doesn't matter which one of those two it goes in, as long as it doesn't go into common. So for ease of my drawing, I'm just gonna bring this cable out a little bit that way and just bring that line up into the loop. So I've taken one down into L1 or L2. So that would be my permanent line coming down. We said, didn't we, that the next bit gotta be really careful of, because this is not a neutral, okay? This one here is not a neutral. Okay, so I'm gonna bring this one, which is blue coming down to the switch, is actually my switching line. So I'm gonna need to bring that down correctly. So my switching line comes out of here, like so. So I can bring that down there. And I can bring it across and into there. I could have had these two the other way around, doesn't matter. It's just showing the cables coming down, permanent line comes down, and not a neutral. We looked at it before, we said it was switching line. So this cable comes down here to the switch with permanent line, CPC, and switching line. We must put on some brown sleeve in order to identify that, not as a neutral, but as a switching line. And we do that simply by putting a little bit of a brown tag on the drawing in each of those positions. Okay, so there we go, we've got those. So now we've got to work out what cable links our two-way switches together. And that's gonna be this one here. This is our 3-core and CPC. And again, you can see only one of the conductors is brown. We've got black and gray, and the two that we are using for switching line conductors, being gray and black, will need identifying with brown sleeving, and of course, green and yellow sleeving on our CPC. So if we have this cable coming down here as we would in a one-way switch, so exactly what we've got here, we had a blue, a brown, and a green and yellow coming down to a one-way switch. In the real world, all you need to do is leave that cable in place, take off the one-way switch and replace it for a two-way switch, making brown and blue with brown sleeving in L1 and L2, and then just introduce a 3-core from the switching position you've already got to a new switching position. So that's what we're gonna do here. So this is just simply one cable from the switch to the other switch, 3-core and CPC. We need to find the right colors. So I need a black pen, I need a gray pen, and I need a brown pen. So let's start with the gray, okay? It doesn't matter which one I choose, but I'm gonna come out of here. So I'm gonna bring my gray conductor to link this one to this one here. So I just take that down to there, and that's my gray connection. And then what I need to do is identify it with brown sleeving, both ends. My black's gonna link my two commons together. This is the important one, to link my two commons together. So the black will come down and link my two commons together. And again, we identify that with a bit of brown sleeving on both sides. And then the next one of the three core, this brown one here, is going to connect to the brown of the twin and CPC cable. If you imagine, that comes down as a permanent line connection and then strikes onto the brown one, meaning that that will always be connected to the permanent line connection. So that's why I always make that one brown. So I bring that one down as well, like so. And that's introduced my three core cable. I've just got to now make sure I put the CPC in. So I bring my CPC down. And again, some of my students do like to strike the side of that with a little bit of yellow. So what we've done there is just simply had the original one-way switch maybe, and we've changed that now for a two-way switch. And this one here is a two-way switch. And all we've done is introduce one more cable. This cable will be in a three core and CPC. We've put the permanent line, say in L1 or L2, doesn't matter which, the switching line, okay, which we had before in L1 or L2, doesn't matter which, but it's important that we linked our two commons together, and we kept that as black, and we had the brown strapper and the grey strapper coming down as well. So these are sometimes called strappers, so let's follow the circuit through, see if we can work out whether the light fitting is on. So my permanent line connection comes up into the looping terminal, it comes down to here. It goes down here, but look at the blade. It also goes down this blade here, and the line connection is connected to this one here, this blade here, and up this gray one here, onto the switching line here. And yes, in that position there, with the two blades as they are now, this lamp would illuminate. So this would be illuminated at that stage. How do I turn it off? Well, if it's on, it should be, it doesn't matter which switch you turn. So whichever switch you operate, it should go off. So let's move this one fictitiously into the other position. So it's going to come across to here. So it comes, permanent line comes in through the loop down here. Well, this blade now is over to here, so it only goes down here. And this blade also is open, so it doesn't turn it on. Okay, in this position here, we can see it's on. If we turn this blade and this blade, so I moved this one across, and then this one across, we can follow the line through down here. So this one's across over here, it would come down here. This blade would be over, it would come back up the common. Remember, this blade would be over and the lamp would illuminate. So these two bladed positions, if it's off and you operate one of them, the light will illuminate. If it's on and you operate one of them, the lamp will go off and therefore will not be illuminated. Exactly the same as before, we can extend the circuit through. So if this was in, say, bedroom number one, and you wanted another light and switch in bedroom number two, you simply need a permanent line, neutral and CPC to go through to the next area. So at the looping terminal, we take a permanent line through. We take a neutral connection through to the other area. And then we can take a CPC connection through to the other area and repeat the process again. Let's just put that line on there. So that would go into the looping terminal, that would go into the neutral, and that would go into the earth terminal where the CPC is secured. And you can do a one-way lighting circuit or a two-way, and we'll build it up to be two-way and intermediate. So that's our wiring diagram for our two-way lighting circuit, two positions in order to turn on our light fitting.